Well, hello. I want to give you an update on the tropics here on this Monday afternoon, day after the Independence Day holiday. A lot of people celebrating here on the 5th of July. As you can see, a lot of activity down here near Cuba, just past the storm across the areas around Jamaica a little earlier. Certainly does not look like a classic storm. In fact, if you've followed hurricanes or tropical systems for any length of time, you know this does not certainly look like a hurricane. It was at one point, but now, especially very tall mountains, I want to say maybe 10,000 feet, some of the mountains are in Cuba, whether it's 8,000, 9,000, whatever, that just disrupts the airflow. And as a result, the storm has weakened, still 60 miles per hour, but again, no longer a hurricane. It was up to 75 or maybe even 80 at one point. We do have some tropical storm warnings down here across Cuba. Same thing on up into areas from Key West up the west side to a little bit past Tampa. The storm expected to weaken a little bit more as it gets over land here the next 12 hours and then slowly strengthen as it gets into the Gulf of Mexico. However, notice it's moving fairly rapidly. There's a pretty brisk wind out of the south. We're going to talk more about that and how that'll affect it. But eventually, it just becomes a tropical depression as it moves up just inland through the Carolinas. This is called the cone of uncertainty, and it means the center should pass somewhere generally within that cone. Doesn't make a huge amount of difference if it's over, let's say, sometime Thursday afternoon, which you can see is halfway between Thursday at 8 a.m. and Friday at 8 a.m. So about Thursday evening at 8, roughly, we expect it somewhere here over southeast Virginia or northeastern North Carolina as a strong tropical depression, maybe a very, very, very minimal tropical storm, and then it just catapults rapidly onto the northeast. And you say, is that early in the season? Well, it is. This is the earliest fifth named storm that we've ever had, beating last year by 5 or 6 days. So let's take a look, though. The yellow are hurricanes, and the red are hurricanes and or tropical storms. So you can see the peak. It's a little hard to read here, but it's right around September 10th. So it's the week before September 10th and about a week after. That's where the bulk of the hurricanes occur during the season for the Atlantic. We're way over here, July 5th. And if you follow that line over here, that means only about 10 storms every 100 years. So it is rare for us on this date specifically to have a hurricane or a tropical storm out there. So we are starting early, as I mentioned. Now I want to talk about the wind shear and why that storm, when it gets over the warm waters of the Gulf, is not going to intensify very dramatically. A normal system, you get the winds going up, they start to spin around, and that's a normal hurricane flow. When you have what we call wind shear, mainly aloft, it literally tilts the thing. And so you can't get the strong updrafts in a thunderstorm to go straight up like you typically do. So that disrupts the wind flow. Therefore, they are not as strong as they typically are if you have a tilted system. And right now, this storm is very tilted and should stay tilted with that brisk wind out of the southwest across the Gulf the next couple of days. Now let's talk about quadrants. If this storm heads out over Cape Hatteras, let's say, we talk about the various quadrants, some of them being worse than others. And why is that? Well, let's say the storm is sitting completely still and it's spinning at 50 miles per hour. Now, add in 10 miles per hour of forward speed. Think of it like it's sitting on a train moving at 10 miles per hour. Now you have the 50 mile per hour winds, but the train is moving at 10, so the right side would have 60 mile per hour winds. The left side, you'd have to subtract 10 miles per hour from that 50, so it would be a net 40. So the left side of a storm compared to the path, whatever direction it moves, the left side of the storm has much, much weaker wind fields. So the right front has the strongest winds and typically most, if not all, of the tornadoes. The front left has a significant storm surge, however, and then the right rear has some significant wind, but again, not quite as strong as the front side. And finally, the last quadrant, the back left, is the weakest, but still can be dangerous. So if this storm heads out over Hatteras, we are going to be on the left side. Even if it heads out over northeast North Carolina, that would put the Outer Banks and areas down to the south in the most likely quadrant for the strongest winds, which again aren't going to be terribly strong, and any potential tornadoes. So that's one thing we'll watch. We'll keep an eye on this system. Of course, have updates throughout the week. But for now, that's the very latest on ELSA.